Yo, hey, what's up, guys? It is Saturday, May 5th, and it's free comic book day today. That's right, today was my first ever free comic book day event, and me and my daughter both attended two local comic book stores today, which had a pretty big turnout. And I want to share some video with you in a few seconds. But first, before I jump into it, being the fact this is my first ever comic book day, because last year it was held on May 7th, and May 7th is my birthday, so I didn't attend. So it was kind of weird how that happened, because I heard about Phoenix Comic Con last year around April. I wanted to go to our local comic book store, buy a comic. That never happened because of my birthday. Went later on. Bought the Iron Man, blah, 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 blah. So it's kind of a big thing for me, because this is kind of my first event since last year I wasn't able to attend, and I enjoyed it. I had a really good time. So let me show you some video really quick.
Now, here's a little story I got to tell about three bad brothers you know so well. It started way back in history with that rap.
I'm CAA.
And me.
My team.
Been had a little horsey named Paul Revere. Just me and my horsey and a quart of beer. Across the land, kicking up sand, sheriff's boxes on my tail, cause I'm in demand. One lonely beastie I be, all by myself without nobody. The sun is beating down on my baseball hat, the air is getting hot, the beer is getting flat. Looking for a girl, I ran into a guy, his name is MCA, I said howdy, he said hi.
That was some short video, guys, that I took. I didn't really have time to take a whole lot of video or pictures, only because it was just so many people, and I'm not too quite sure if some of you know or heard me in one of my last videos, but I get freaked out when there's a lot of people. You know, I get nervous, I start to sweat, you know, I just get uncomfortable. And you know what, I just sucked it up like a man, and I shut up and I held through it, because my daughter, she really wanted to get her face painted, which is a picture here. The first one that I did get, Bongo Comics, Free For All, with my favorite Simpsons character, the comic book guy. Next one I got was the New 52. A pretty cool little advertisement there for Samurai Comics. I'm not too quite sure if you guys can tell, but at that video, the event, one of the stores I went to was Samurai Comics. So I was pretty surprised to see they had their own little advertisement here, which was pretty cool. Next one I got was Zombie Kid. Next one, Spider-Man Season 1. Next one, Transformers Regeneration 1. This one I really, really wanted to get, only because this one is supposed, this whole new title, this all new comic book, is supposed to start off at the very end of the Marvel series line back in the 80s, where the Transformers, the comic book, the title, was part of the Marvel comic line. Number 80 was their last issue. This one starts off right after it, so it's 80.5. So I'm excited for this, to read this. Next one, Anna and Fraga. This one's look pretty cool. My daughter liked it. Adventure Time with Peanuts. The Smurfs with Tinkerbell. Next one that I got, guys, here was the one I actually wanted to get for my daughter, Mouse Guard. When I was looking at the art, man, it looks awesome. The artwork in here, I'm like, man, is this for an adult or for a kid? I wasn't too quite sure, but if you take a look at it, it looks really cool. So we're going to have a good time probably reading this tonight or maybe over the week next weekend because she goes to her mom's tonight. One I bought for my daughter, this one, the Skeleton Key. Next one, she really enjoyed this one, was She-Hulk. It's an older issue, She-Hulk number 3, Sensational She-Hulk actually. It has a guest appearance of Spider-Man. She actually enjoyed that and said, hey dad, can I get this? So I think it was like a dollar. And also, guys, at my local comic book store, All About Books and Comics, they had two artist and writer guest appearances there, which wrote and drew Batman Beyond. I actually had them autograph my comic book here, if you can tell, where it says to Rick and Natalie. And that one is Adam Beechin. And then I hope you guys can see this one here. Right there, it says, I don't know if you guys can see it, but it says, hey guys, and that one's from Dustin Nguyen. Dustin Nguyen also was nice enough to give me and my daughter two quick sketches. This one right here is of Poison Ivy, and then he autographed it right there. And he asked my daughter, so who's your favorite character? Now, these two guys are, of course, DC guys, and they're drawing DC. And she goes, Black Widow. And and of course, he didn't really know who Black Widow was. And, you know, I didn't blame him. It's okay. I said, you know what? She's a Marvel girl. She enjoys Marvel comics. So I kind of described Black Widow to Dustin, and he drew her right there. Again, autographed. So he was a really cool guy. Both of them are really cool. They were there for a while signing autographs. And I'm actually glad that I got this autograph because I really enjoyed Batman Beyond. Three more books, guys, that I picked up today before my camera dies. I actually wanted to, you know, contribute, you know, spend some money there because I understand that this event, these free comic books, they're really not free. What I understand was the comic book stores, the dealers, actually have to purchase this from the retailers, and then they give it to their customers for free. And that, I thought, was really cool. So I'm like, you know what, I felt really bad, and, you know, I wanted to go ahead and spend a little bit of money, you know, just to kind of, you know, put into the pot. It's kind of a thank you for doing this event. So I picked up three comics. The first comic book that I picked up, The House of Mystery, number 208. This is an awesome cover. And again, guys, I want to remind all of you, all of my viewers, I'm going to be doing comic book reviews on horror comics in my collection. And I have quite a few. Really cool covers, really awesome art. And you know what? I have to actually admit, most of them have really, really cool stories. So this is the first one, House of Mysteries, number 208. This is a 1970-something comic. If you can tell here, there's two kids. Closed. No one dies today. And of course, it's a Grim Reaper. Next one is House of Mystery, number 207. Awesome, awesome cover again. Another 1970-ish comic book. The last one I picked up, guys, was this House of Mystery, number 174. 12-cent issue, I believe this is 1968 or 67. And this one actually started off retelling of horror-based, eerie-type stories of comics for House of Mystery. What I mean by that, prior to this one, House of Mystery was kind of going like superhero-ish, with the Martian Manhunter. up until 173, and then it went back into horror mystery into 174. But again, I'll share that story a little bit better with you guys later on after Comic-Con, so probably next month. But really, really cool titles, really, really cool cover art. Just awesome, pure awesome. So that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, let me know. Hit me up. But enjoy Free Comic Book Day like I did. And thank you to all the dealers. If any of the dealers are watching this video, thank you. We really appreciate it. Me and my daughter had a really good time at All About Books and Comics and Samurai Comics. So again, thank you and stay tuned for another video pretty shortly.